Hello everyone and welcome to another short video tutorial on Wallacei.X. In this tutorial we're going to look into using the diamond chart and displaying and visualizing the diamond chart next to multiple solutions exported from the Wallacei simulation. So I'm using the normal example file that you'll find in the Wallacei download folder, and I've already run a simulation and I've connected to my phenotype here the meshes, the mesh outputs. This is just going to make the visualization process a little bit quicker since meshes are lighter. I'm going to open my user interface, and as you can see, I ran a generation size of 10 and generation count of 50. It took 31 seconds. I'm going to go into the third tab, draw the parallel coordinate plot, which would allow me to export solutions from the simulation. I'm going to export any two random generations, add them to the export list, and click export. This tells me how long the export time is going to take. So I will just wait until the export is finished. And so when it's done, I'm going to go back to my Rhino and Grasshopper windows. So the first thing I'm going to do is use the distributor components. If you're not familiar with this component, please go to our Wallacei YouTube page. There's a dedicated video specifically for this component. I'll also put a link to it in the description below. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to simply distribute the exported solutions on a grid. So I'm just going to connect my fitness values and my phenotypes. By default, this component is preview off, so I'm just going to enable the preview. And now I have all my solutions distributed on the grid, the number of solutions, and so on and so forth. I have a double solution here because this is the one of them is the original solution that is turned on from before my simulation. So I'm just going to turn that off. So what I want to do now is I want to visualize the diamond chart next to or underneath each one of these exported solutions. So I'm going to go into my Wallacei tab and use the diamond chart. So there are a few components I'm going to need before I can visualize the solutions. First things first, I'm going to need to insert the fitness values. So I'm going to get all of the original fitness values and insert them into the diamond chart. However, I can't insert them directly. I'm going to need a component from up here, from Wallacei Utilities. This is just going to reorder the tree path so that it better fits and works with our fitness chart components. This is just for this version. Future versions, you will most likely not have this component. Secondly, what I need to do is I need to input the size of the generation. So in this case, my generation size was 10. And so now I have the data necessary to draw the diamond charts. The only thing missing is I need to inform this component what generations and individuals do I want to visualize. I already have this data from this W phenotype component. So when I export the W phenotype component, I get the solutions in a tree structure in which the paths are the locations of those solutions. So in this case, this is solution generation 28, individual 0, and so on and so forth. So what I need to do is I need to extract from this tree these paths, these numbers here. To do that, I will use tree statistics. So I'll start off with that. And this is going to give me in a list the paths of each item in that list. What I'll do next is I will deconstruct these paths. And what this will give me is, in a list, each path item. So generation 28, individual 0, 28, 1, and so on and so forth. Lastly, I'm going to list these items so that I get two outputs, which is the first item in the list and the second item in the list. The first item being the generation, and the second item being the individual. In doing so, I can input these two values in here, and what I should get is at my 0, 0, because that's a default plane, many charts, many diamond charts. So what I need to do now is I need to distribute or put the diamond chart next to each solution, its relative solution. One of the outputs of this distributor component is this grid here, which is the point in which this phenotype is located, in which the solution is located. So I can essentially use these grid of points and input this into my plane here. and it's going to draw each diamond chart next to its relative phenotype. I'm still not very happy with this location, so what I'll do is I'll simply move these grid of points. So I'm just going to move them with a XYZ vector. I already have some values that I've tested before, so I'm going to move it in the X and specific amount, and let's say in the Y, and I'm going to input these points there. So I'm relatively happy with the location. I need to modify the size. I just need to make them a little bit bigger. So I'll modify this scale here in the diamond chart with a larger value. And I can control that as I wish. And that way you have the diamond charts with the ranking of each criteria located under each specific solution. Obviously, we can modify the size of the grid so that there's more space. So for example, I'll make this around 500, this Y here. I can modify this a little bit just so that we have better visuals. And that's it. That's how easy it is. With just a few components, you can extract significantly more data and have the visualization and presentation process that much clearer. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the next video. Goodbye.